Observing the Earth and the ocean in real time is central to provide information on our habitat for the benefits of our societies. The European Copernicus Programme provides the eye for observation and the platform to archive and distribute observation products, educate and train future data providers and users is central to our society. Sorbonne University is contributing to this goal. The ocean constitutes 70% of the surface of the Earth and 90% of all the volume available for life. The ocean regulates weather and climate. Properties such as temperature and many other constitute the ecological niche and shape the spatial distribution of all living forms in the ocean, including phytoplankton. The oceans support economic activities in various domains, such as trade, fisheries, and energy. The ocean provides cultural services, such as recreational, educational, and spiritual services. But the ocean is under global and local anthropogenic pressure, changing its state and threatening our society. Among major challenges, we can cite sea temperature rise, ocean acidification, deoxygenation, overexploitation of fisheries resources, and pollution and destruction of habitats. Copernicus Programme is an EU program managed by the European Commission and implemented in partnerships with the member states and EU's agencies, and also Mercator Ocean. The Copernicus Marine Environmental Monitoring Service provides regular and systematic observation about the physical state and the dynamics of the Earth system. The first step is to observe the Earth remotely from space using the Sentinel satellites and also using in-situ observation with a good space coverage. The second step is to conceive and share products after different levels of quality control. In the next step, services and applications are developed by intermediate users to produce products that will serve the end users. Sorbonne University participates to Copernicus by providing expertise with its network of scientists, by providing data as a partner of the French ODATIS Ocean Cluster, and of course, by providing training to students, training for PhDs and internships, but also training at master level for the Sciences de la Mer and also for the International IMBSC Master Program.
I work on a biological carbon pump through the use of in-situ imaging instruments such as the underwater vision profiler 5. This instrument gives me images of plankton organisms that I convert into individual biovolume and then biomass. One of my scientific questions is, can we estimate global plankton biomass using sparse data and habitat modeling? To do so, I use a multivariate approach using satellite observation from Copernicus for the chlorophyll A. This product has a spatial resolution of 4 km and a temporal resolution of daily, monthly, and climatology. I use an R script to download the monthly data on my computer as netcdf files, one per month. I open them using the script and then include the chlorophyll A data with the other variables. The habitat model will learn the association between the environmental variables and the biomass of the plankton groups by using a regression. This model would then be able to do a prediction of the biomass over all the points in the ocean for each group, giving the map you have here, for example, for epipelagic copepods.
Thank you to all contributors in the training of young researchers to marine science, and also to Copernicus. And welcome to Sorbonne University.